From the KATC Weather Lab, here's Dave's forecast.
651, almost 652 here in Lafayette. We're at 37 degrees. We've still got a little bit of light drizzle out there, and man, it is windy out there. Winds out of the north-northeast at 23, gusting at times to 33. That produces a wind chill of 26, so you need to bundle up. Gloves, hat, heavy coat is what you're going to need to head out to work and school. These temperatures aren't going to change a whole lot today. We might get our way back into the lower 40s, but that's about it. Wind chills are going to stay in the 30s for most of the afternoon. 38 both at Brobridge and St. Martinville, 38 now in Crowley. Got a pair of 39s here in Jeff Davis Parish from Jennings over to Welsh, 37 in Lake Charles, and a very chilly 36 degrees over into Quincy. And it feels very, very cold, not just because of the wind, but it was almost 80 degrees yesterday here in the Acadiana area. So it's feeling nearly 50 degrees colder than where we were this time yesterday. As far as our skies, they're going to remain gray for the early part of the day. Then they'll clear out tonight, and that's when the hard freeze warning will kick in. For most of Acadiana, it's a hard freeze warning. Freeze warning down to the south. If you watch the bottom of your screen here, it'll give you the details of each individual region, whether it's central Louisiana, 190, I-10, or coastal, how long those freezing temperatures will last, what the temperature will drop down to, and what precautions you need to take. If you miss it, go to KATC.com, click on the story called Windy and Cold, and it will give you all of that information. We do have the rains that will continue to spread over toward New Orleans, some wintry precip back to the west, but a lot of this so far is not reaching the ground. Most of our surface reports aren't reporting any rain or any snow there, which is an indication a lot of this is evaporating before it reaches the ground. But there may be a couple of snow flurries out here over the Piney Woods, maybe even up to around Toledo Bend before all wraps up. Futurecast shows the clouds sticking around through at least midday, and then hopefully we'll start to see some sunshine later in the afternoon. Now tonight, that's when the temperatures are going to start to tumble and our wind speeds will diminish. Should be below the freezing point as early as 10. We're going to bottom out around 26 degrees here in Lafayette and stay below freezing until about 9 or 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. So the I-10 corridor, you can expect freezing temperatures to last between 10 and 12 hours. Plants, pets, and highly recommended if you have exposed pipes to get those wrapped. Pretty good idea to do it anyway, because you're probably going to need to have that done before the winter is over. It still is early November, and we've got several cold blasts that could come in before the winter is over. Wind chills are also going to be an issue, hovering around 30 most of the day, dropping back into the upper 20s overnight tonight. Some areas may even see the wind chills drop into the teens briefly before the sun comes up tomorrow. So expect your high to be around 44. This is if we get some sunshine this afternoon. Wind chills will remain in the 20s and 30s most of the day. Rain chance at 40%. That's pretty much going to be winding down here within the next couple of hours over the coastal parishes. Inland areas are pretty much going to be rain free for the rest of the day, except for perhaps a little bit of mist. Tonight we're going to run it down to 26. Tomorrow up to 50 with some sunshine. 40% chance for showers on Thursday with cloudy skies. And then as we head toward the weekend, Katie and I are eating gumbo at a gumbo eating or gumbo cook-off. And I think we've got the perfect weather on Saturday with a high of 57. It could be a little frosty though, Saturday and Sunday morning with temperatures hovering around 30. We're going to get a little more spring-like, I think, by the middle part of next week with temperatures back in the 70s.